Hi, and welcome back to Daily Planet. I'm Seamus O'Regan.
And I'm Zai Tong. If you want to stimulate your brain and simultaneously enjoy the experience, you've come to the right place.
You sure have. Still to come, we have a positively hoggerific mind bender, complete with a pig called Hogzilla.
Plus, on Weird Planet, we'll peel out for one very strange piece of art.
And later, Jay may not be here in the studio this week, but he will make an appearance on Jay's Journal, doggone it.
But first, dung beetles. You know those cute little beetles that roll up in
the
balls
dung?
Of poop and push them along?
Oh,
they're pretty
so
amazing
tender.
Creatures. Well, there's actually nearly 8,000 different types of them, and they don't just live in Africa either. They live on every continent except Antarctica.
Well, in New Zealand, they have a very large population of farm animals, but there, only a couple of species of dung beetle have any interest in eating cow patties. That is, until now.
A revolution is about to start in New Zealand. And these will be the leaders. Dung beetles. Shaun Forgie is a scientist with Landcare Research in New Zealand.
G'day, Bernard. How are you going?
Hi, Sean.
Doing good?
Today, he's in Australia to collect thousands of dung beetles.
I love getting my fingers dirty with dung beetles. I'm very passionate about these things.
He wants to take these home to clean up New Zealand's poop problem.
Like many other developing agricultural countries, we brought in all of this livestock, and one cow defecates, 11 to 13 times a day? You get a rapid accumulation of dung on a pasture surface, and that contributes quite significantly to forage fowl. That accumulation ends up in a reduction in pastoral surface area available for grazing. And then there's all these other things, like surface runoff. You get all these nutrients sitting on the surface, get run off and contribute to contaminating waterways. There's all sorts of problems. Now, if you can get rid of that dung beneath the soil surface and put it into soil horizon, you get all of these fantastic benefits.
Dung beetles are really efficient at cleaning up crap. This is a freshly laid cow patty. And this is it 48 hours later.
As far as I'm concerned, they're the most charismatic of all the beetles, really. They've got such perfect personalities, and it's not just that, but it's also the way in which they do what they do. I mean, they live and breed in dung, and it's the processes in which they bury the dung in the tunneling that have all of these fantastic spin-offs, you know, in the ecology and environmental impacts. They're so beneficial.
Shaun has waited 15 years for this day.
This is such a fantastic opportunity now. You know, we've been working on it, on trying to develop this project to get beetles into New Zealand, exotic dung beetles into New Zealand. So, yeah, very, very excited about the idea that we've been given the thumbs up.
He's received permission to introduce 11 new species of dung beetle into New Zealand. The first two he'll collect here with the help of Dr. Bernard Doube.
With the beetle.
Well, it's a fresh pad. Well, it's been down for a couple of hours.
Yep.
And it's got all three species in it, so fulvus, binotus and torus.
God, this is heaving, isn't it?
And it must have 1,000 beetles in it, I reckon. I mean, they've been flying in for the last couple of hours. They're quite fantastic. Look at that.
New Zealand's got a few native dung beetles, but nothing in the pastures where the livestock cattle are. So I've come to Australia because these guys have spent quite a lot of time introducing really efficient dung beetles into the pastures, and over here we can collect them that are in very similar habitats to what we expect to see in parts of New Zealand, or pretty much most of all New Zealand.
Australia started introducing new dung beetles 20 years ago.
Here we have tunnels going down into the subsoil, and these one of the major constraints in agriculture in Australia and in New Zealand is that these subsoils, these tough clay subsoils, have got nothing to get through into them. But these dung beetles take tunnels right down to about 40, 50 centimetres and break up that subsoil and bring it to the surface. So it's going to be a fantastic thing for New Zealand, as it already is for parts of Australia.
Bernard's been watching the Australian population and is seeing their impact firsthand.
This is the plots with beetles and dung.
Yep.
And we're comparing that with the plots with have only dung.
So we're getting 30% more grass. Now that should be
That's pretty good, isn't it?
In New Zealand, shouldn't it?
Well, you look that into a large scale, that's pretty productive when you think about it.
Dung beetles don't work year-round. That's why Shaun is looking to introduce 11 different species.
Not all species are abundant all year-round. Some are active in spring, some in autumn, some in winter. So we need an array of beetles that cover all seasons. There's also different types of soil requirements and climate requirements too. So we've got to take all of those into account in order to choose the ones that'll be present for us to cover it for that length of time. So this is fulvus. This is one of the two species that we're going to be bringing into New Zealand in the next wee while.
Here we have a taurus. In fact, it's a male taurus because you can see those horns on either side of the, on the coming out, great big backward-facing horns. That's why it's called taurus, of course.
They gather them, then sort them, and get them ready for shipping.
They will be packaged in a way that we know that they'll last for quite a few days. The courier process itself will only last a couple of days at max. One thing there will be is that they'll be very hungry because they'll be being starved a little bit to make sure that their tummies are empty of any dung or anything that the dung contains, because we need them to have a nice, clean, fit bill of health when they come into quarantine to speed up their time in quarantine.
Once they clear quarantine, they'll breed them and release them all over New Zealand.
It's going to take some time to get all of the species in and all in the appropriate areas around the country and get the populations built up the way we want them to. But to see the true benefits, that might take a few generations at least of these things naturally reproducing in the field.
Not many people would be excited about years of mucking around in dung, but Shaun couldn't be happier.
I'm looking forward to as many years as I can being associated with these dung beetles. I'm so excited about the fact that they're coming into New Zealand and they're going to be doing great things for us.